when we see some people who are brilliant performers, be they in sports, in singing, in dance, in acting, even in computer programming, in teaching, in leadership, in mathematics, whatever field it may be. When we see some people who are excellent performance, we often doubt it. How can they do this so well? And most often, when we see our inability to do anything even comparable remotely with what they're doing, we start thinking, these people are phenomenally talented. And it is because of their talent, they are able to do such astonishing things. And yes, there are people who are extraordinarily gifted. And their excellence could be partially attributed to their talent. But at the same time, it's not talent alone. Because it's more of their commitment. When we do something repeatedly and each time try to do it as well as we can, and by that, we keep improving steadily. Some players, say for example in tennis, are almost like serving machines. Just serve so effectively. Ace after ace after ace, or unreturnable serve after unreturnable serve. How do they get to that level? That is because they practice their serve so much. Or consider, for example, an archer. There are some archers, you may see them in the Olympics match, and they just hit the gold medal. They get the gold medal by hitting the bullseye. Now, how did they get to hit the bullseye? It is not that the first time they picked up a gun and shot and they got to the bullseye. They practice hundreds, thousands, maybe millions of times. And each time aiming as carefully as they can. And slowly they move from the outer periphery of the outer circle to the inner circle to a still inner circle. And eventually they get to the bullseye and they get to the center of the bullseye. So like that, we all become improved by regular practice. And excellence is a result of that practice. And practice is not just something which is effortful. Over a period of time, the practice becomes a habit.